Good morning, children. Welcome to Accountancy online class. Today we are going to see about company accounts. Let us recall what we have studied in the previous classes. And the next one is about under subscription. So what is under subscription? When the number of shares subscribed is less than the number of shares offered, it is known as under subscription. Next, we have studied about oversubscription. When the number of shares applied for it is more than the number of shares offered for subscription, it is called as oversubscription. Then we have studied about calls in advance. The excess of amount paid over the called up value of a share is known as calls in advance. Calls in arrears means when a shareholder fails to pay the amount due on allotment or on calls, the amount remaining unpaid is known as calls in arrears. Children, do you remember what is forfeiture of share? When a shareholder defaults in making payment of allotment and or call money, the shares may be forfeited. Premium means when the company issues shares at a price more than the face value or nominal value, the shares are said to be issued at premium. Children, let us do one problem. Okay. Divya Limited allotted 10,000 equity shares of rupees 10 each at a premium of rupees 2 per share to applicants of 14,000 shares on a pro rata basis. The excess application money will be adjusted towards allotment money. The amount payable was rupees 2 on application, rupees 5 on allotment including premium of rupees 2 each, and rupees 3 on first call and rupees 2 on final call. Because a shareholder failed to pay the first call and final call on his 300 shares, all the shares were forfeited. And out of them, 200 shares were reissued at rupees 9 per share. Pass the necessary journal entries. Okay, children, shall we record the journal entries? The first step, you have to write the format. Date, particulars, ledger folio, debit, credit. So, the first journal entry is for receiving the applications. So, bank account debit, how much they are receiving the applications? 14,000 at the rate of 28,000 to equity share application account. So application money for 14,000 shares received. Then it should be transferred to capital account. Actually the company needs only 10,000 equity shares. So there is an excess of 4,000 shares that has to be refunded. Equity share application account 14,000 minus 4,000 10,000 at the rate of 20,000. To equity share capital account. Application money transferred to share capital. Children, in the problem it is given that excess application money should be adjusted towards allotment. So the journal entry is equity share application account. How much is excess applications? 4,000. 14,000 minus 10,000. 4,000 at the rate of 2. To equity share allotment, so 8,000. Excess application money adjusted towards allotment. And the next one is allotment money due. So the journal entry is equity share allotment account. So how much? 10,000 shares. The rate is 5. To equity share capital, because premium is included in allotment. So what is the rate of premium? 2. So, equity share capital account 10,000 into 3, 30,000, and securities premium account 10,000 into 2, 20,000. So, this journal entry is for allotment money due. Next journal entry is for allotment money received. Children, that excess application money, how much? 4,000 shares. At the rate of 8,000 rupees, that is adjusted in the allotment money. So now the journal entry is bank account debit 50,000 minus 8,000. 42,000 to equity share allotment account. Allotment money received. The next journal entry is for receiving the call money. So children, of course, you know the journal entry. Equity share first call account 10,000 into 330,000 to equity share capital account. That is call amount due. We have to receive 30,000 rupees. But in the problem, it is given one shareholder because he failed to pay 300 shares on first call. So while receiving the money, we have to reduce 300 shares. So bank account 10,000 minus 300, 9,700, rate is 3. To equity share first call, 29,100, 29,100. First call money received for 9,700 shares. Because a shareholder fails to pay 300 shares on first call. Now for the second call. Of course, children, you also know this journal entry. So what is the journal entry? Equity share second and final call account debit to equity share capital. This is amount due. So 10,000, the rate is 2. 20,000, 20,000. Now the next journal entry is for receiving the call money. But look at the problem. Because a shareholder, he failed to pay not only the first call, He did not pay the final call also. Of how many shares? 300 shares. So bank account 10,000 minus 300, 9,700. And the rate is 2. 2 equity share second and final call, 19,400. So second and final call money received for 9,700 shares. Okay, children, now the next journal entry is for forfeiture of shares. Okay, so because he failed to pay 300 shares on first call and final call. So equity share capital account 300. What is the rate? 10. 3000. So to equity share first call 300. What is the rate of first call? 3 rupees. 900. And what is the rate of second call? 2 rupees. So, 2 equity share second and final call, 300 into 2, 600. So, what is the balance? 2 shares forfeited, 1500. So, out of 10 shares, first call is 3 rupees, second call is 2 rupees, and Vikas has failed to pay both the first call and the final call. So, the balance is 5. So, shares forfeited, 300 into 5 is 1500. So forfeiture of 300 shares for non-payment of first and second call. So after forfeiting the shares, children, why we are crediting the shares forfeited? Because it's an income to the company. After that, the company will reissue the shares. So out of 300, the company is reissuing only 200 shares, and that too at the rate of 9. So what is the journal entry? Bank account 200 into 9,800. Shares forfeited 200 into 1, 200. To equity share capital account 2000. Amount of forfeited shares for 300 shares. That is 1500. The company gained rupees 1500. Then out of 300 shares, it reissued 200 shares. So now let us do the calculation. What is the formula? Amount of forfeited shares by number of forfeited shares into reissue of forfeited shares. So 1500 by 300 into 200, that gives 1000 rupees. Less loss on reissue, 200. So there is a gain of 800. Where we have to transfer this amount? To capital reserve. So now let us record the journal entry for the gain amount. So what is the journal entry? Shares forfeited account debit 800 to capital reserve account 800. Children, let us do one more sum. I'll read the sum. You listen carefully. Then we will record the journal entries. X company issued 10,000 equity shares of rupees 10 each payable as under. On application rupees 2, on allotment rupees 4, on first call rupees 2, on final call rupees 2. Applications were received for 30,000 shares. Application for 10,000 shares were rejected and allotment was made proportionately towards remaining applications. And the excess application money is adjusted towards allotment money. The directors made both the calls and all the amount were received, except the final call on 600 shares, which was subsequently forfeited. Later, 400 forfeited shares were reissued as fully paid by receiving rupees 7 per share. Give journal entries. Okay, now what is the first step? You have to write the format. What is the format? In the books of X company, journal entries, date, particulars, ledger folio, debit, credit. Children, what is the first journal entry for receiving the application money? So, how many applications we have received? 30,000. So, what is the journal entry? Bank account, debit, 30,000 and the rate of application is 2. 2 equity share application account, 60,000. Application money received on 30,000 shares at the rate of rupees 2 per share. Now the next one, it should be transferred to share capital account. So how much we have to transfer to share capital? Only 10,000 shares. So equity share application 10,000, the rate is 2. 2 equity share capital account 20,000. Share application transfer to share capital. The next one is for the refund of the rejected applications. Children, how many shares they have rejected? They have rejected 10,000 shares. So now the journal entry is equity share application account debit to bank. That is 10,000 into 2. And in the sum it is given that excess application money has been allotted with allotment money. So 2 equity share allotment 10,000 into 2. So excess application is allotted with allotment money. So 10,000 into 2. So total is 40,000. Application money, refund for rejected applications and excess application money adjusted towards allotment. Now for allotment money due. So allotment money 10,000 into at the rate of 4, 40,000 to equity share capital. Then for receiving the allotment money, that is 40,000 minus 20,000. So bank account to equity share allotment 20,000 allotment money received. So children, after the allotment money, what is the next installment? Call money. So the first journal entry is for call money due. Equity share first call 10,000 into 2 to equity share capital 20,000. So after the call money due, you have to receive the call money. Bank account debit to equity share first call 20,000. Children, now the company has made the second and the final call. So equity share second and final call 10,000, the rate is 20,000 to equity share capital account. So share second and final call due. First journal entry is for the due amount. Now you have to receive the call money. See, the directors have made both the calls and all the money were received except on 300 shares. So what the company did? The company forfeited the shares. So now the journal entry is bank account 10,000 minus 600, 9,400 and the rate is 2. 2 equity share second and final call 18,800, 18,800. So second and final call money received on 9,400 shares. So now we have to record the journal entry for the forfeiture of shares. The company has received all the money except on the final call. The 600 shares the company has not received. So the company has forfeited the 600 shares. Now children, what is the journal entry? It is an income to the company, so it should be credited. So equity share capital 600 into 10 and 2 equity share second and final call. Only on the final call a person has not paid 600 shares. The company has not received 600 shares on the final call. So equity share second and final call 600 into 2200. So 2 forfeiture of shares 600 into 8 4800. It is credited because it is an income to the company. Shares forfeited for non-payment of final call money. So 600 shares were forfeited. After that, the company has reissued 400 shares at the rate of rupees 7 per share. So now the journal entry is bank account 400 into 7, 2800. Forfeited shares is 400 into 3, 1200. 2 equity share capital 400 into 10, 4000. 400 forfeited shares reissued at rupees 7 per share. So the company, out of 600 shares, it reissued 400 shares at the rate of 7. So the company has forfeited 600 shares and it is reissued 400 shares. Now we have to find out whether that it is a gain or loss to the business. So amount of forfeited shares for 600 is equal to 4800. So for 400 shares you have to calculate, because out of 600 shares 400 was reissued. So the amount credited for 600 shares is 4800. So now what is the formula? Amount of forfeited shares by number of shares forfeited into number of shares reissued. 4800 by 600 into 400, that is 3200. So from 3200 you have to deduct the loss on reissue 1200. So there is a gain of rupees 2000. So what you have to do with this amount? It should be transferred to capital reserve account. So the journal entry is forfeited shares account debit to capital reserve 2000 rupees. Gain on reissue credited to capital reserve account. These are your homework questions. Learn the answers. Thank you, children. Have a nice day.